basically said that all safe lands were once unknown frontiers. What happens here is at Disrupt Space, everyone is trying to understand how do we explore this unknown land that is space.
The future of space, the future of humanity is that there are many different actors have to be playing in. It's not just the work of institutes and large industrial players, but also startups and small to medium enterprises. And I think the future will be very much defined by the interactions of all these players. And it is nice to see all of them come together in one forum and finding Disrupt Space that really gives a voice to each one of the players in this domain.
It's a good place actually to have a filter of for first talks, for first contacts. And you have that in a startup environment. We do that quite often in our accelerators in Berlin as well, but also in San Francisco.
Last year we had more investment in startups than in the last 15 years, and I think what we're actually seeing is a mindset change. So before, people were reliant on governments, government organisations such as ESA or NASA, but now actually what we're seeing is that individuals can do it, and we're getting the appetite from the investors. In the Silicon Valley, they're talking about how we're in the same place now with space as we were with the internet 25 years ago. So you're getting more of an appetite for investors, which is enabling more startups to actually go ahead with their plans and their ideas, and more people to think outside the box, I guess, and to actually look at other possible avenues in order to push forward the frontiers of space exploration.
I think we have this event because at the moment space is kind of rigid, so therefore I think it's good to create this kind of events that we are also are connecting people who might not always be involved in space, but people who are very into space.
What's happened today is we are actually talking to the individuals who are building the highways, the power plants, the roads, you know, the trains of space. These will never be cheap in the sense of we see it today at scale. But we finally are in an opportunity where for really very little cost, we can prove that it is a viable business and it will be a sustainable business going forward. And that means it opens up the opportunities we never had before.
It is sometimes tough from different entities to hear the voice of each other, and Disrupt Space really offers us the opportunity to go beyond our regular horizon and get feedback and maybe exchange ideas with some of the most innovative companies, the future big players and the current big players, and all of them to come to a common understanding of our future, what future should be holding.
The first time actually I see a kind of similar activity in for space dedicated.
Like we can point out the little things. In my field, I see X. Biology will go here, computing will go there. And we do our best to do it. But if you ask how the world will look like in 5 years, we are going to struggle collectively to answer that question.
Thank you.